It is this life that we celebrate this day. And Peter goes from being a cowering man to a bold man, and even to some extent in your face about it. Because the truth is that important. The why is much more important than the how. And this is the why, the answer to the human question. The question posed to each human being by the fact of a tomb, by the fact of our grave. There is a question to be answered. This Jesus of Nazareth is the answer to that why of humanity. Christ is risen. That is the answer. And it is for us every Sunday to unfold its truth into our personal lives. If it's not an every Sunday thing, you're wasting your time today. This is why the church obligates every Catholic to come to Mass every Sunday, because of the why of it all. We make room for him in our Sunday schedule because he made room for us in his eternity. That's a lot longer. Some time ago, a young woman told me of a friend of hers who said that she doesn't like to go to Mass because they always talk about death. Well, yeah, we do talk about it. It is a kind of a reality in human life. Everybody will be affected by that very personally. But we would be mere charlatans and mere dreamers of utopia, which is popular these days in the 20th century. But that's just dreaming. What we say about death, indeed, what we proclaim about death, is the death of death. Christ is risen. This is the central reality of our life. Life belongs to us. Period. From when? From there. And it is for us to take joy in it, to be excited about it, just like a certain pastor might be when he's preaching. Because it's an exciting reality that many forget. Yes, some of us too, when life can be kind of difficult, remember, we forget that life belongs to us. Life is good, and life is a gift from the moment of conception. This is the news that we prepare ourselves to hear during the season of Lent. As we together journeyed through Lent, this is the good news for which we dispose ourselves during the disciplines of Lent. Renewed zeal for confession. Letting God unburden you. Why pay a psychiatrist $200 an hour? And the poor priest is doing that for free. Hello? It is this unburdening that we need, the reminder that God is on our side. The renewed efforts at prayer, taking time each day to recollect, especially in the evening, and not going to sleep on our anger and on our worry. And of course, fasting, denying ourselves. It's not part of our popular culture. Well, diet, but that's still egocentric. we give it up for someone else, not merely selfishly for ourselves. And then there's that almsgiving, being generous. Generous and putting our hands in our pocket to give a serious donation. All of this is part of the Lenten preparation. And this is all acted on in order to open and to clear our minds and spirits for the truth. The truth about who we are. If we shrink from the question posed by our mortality, we become deaf and blind. Deaf and blind to the joyous light of Christ, who said, "I am the way, the truth, the life." Little wonder why Pope John Paul II constantly reiterated, when we look at Christ, man understands himself, knows himself. My brother Hank used to build electron accelerators. And one time he reflected on a presentation given by an elderly physicist. This renowned professor spoke about the fact that once in his youth, and in the excitement of constantly new discoveries being made, it seemed a common assumption among most of his colleagues that God was now on the unemployment line. But this revered professor said that this is now all changing. The more he sees of electrons, and the more he realizes that we will never know, the realization increases that the why of humanity is not to be found in the question posed by a preoccupation with how. The profound sense that confronts this physicist and others is that the why of humanity must be sought in the face of the who. Just this past Monday, I was at a lecture at St. Joseph's. They had an anniversary day, the third anniversary of Pope Benedict's visit to our community and at their church. And this year they had another lecture, and it was by an astrophysicist originally from Australia. His English was a little harder to understand, but we got through that. And he is a Protestant, but he's married to a Catholic, but seems to be going to Mass every Sunday at the Baltimore Cathedral. But he came to speak about the relationship of science and religion, and said pretty much similar things of the how and the why that he used over his purpose. Purpose. Science can measure things and how things would work, but it is incompetent to talk about purpose, the why. And mentioned that it's, a lot of people don't realize it, but a very minority of scientists are atheists, less than 25%. 75% are believers to one extent or another, and 25% of those 75 are identified, whether Christians or Jews. But the more we see, the more we wonder, and the more we know that the important question is not only how, but why. And that purpose is to be found in whose shroud was neatly rolled up in the tomb? Jesus Christ, the risen one, the only Son of God, who resurrected from the dead. That is why Sunday Mass, this weekly celebration of Easter, is so crucial, and it is grave sin to miss it. What are we talking about here? The most important reality in humanity is celebrated on Sunday. But the gravity the church puts onto this element and this third commandment, in a strange way, bears witness to the extraordinary love that's offered. That is why it's grave, because the love is so deep and so wide. Nailed up for all to see. If I were to tell you that my mother died in 98, but if I were to tell you before then that I love my mother very much, and she lived in Queens, and then you ask me, well, when is the last time you visited her? And I would respond to you, I think it was last Christmas. Well, maybe it was Easter. Maybe Palm Sunday. Ashes and palms, Catholics, or just Easter Catholics. Then you would certainly wonder, you have the right to wonder about the truth of my devotion to my mother. You would probably think I'm insane and stupid, and so you would be, so I would be, if I would tell you that I love my mother. When's the last time you saw her? Well, was it Palm Sunday? Was it Easter? Would it not be ever more important for me than to be present to the one who loves me even more than my mother? Yes, God loves me more than my mother could ever love me, and even more than I can ever love myself. If I put myself on the center of my day called Sunday, how important is that? But there is one who loves me more than I love myself. And I put him on the top of the schedule for my Sunday. And so the church's witness to the Sunday Mass is central to our life. It means that to miss would be to deny such complete and absolute love extended to you. The commandment bears witness to love, the who of that love. This day and every Sunday is all for love of you. May our bodies, may our minds, and our souls continue to love and live the life offered on this most grand feast of feasts. Christ is risen, and happy Easter.